this book took me some years to imagine and then to write. So that's why it's a long story. It's also a long story because it has so many characters. You know, the one brought the other characters kept coming. So we have one main character. Apparently, you see one or two main characters. This guy who becomes transparent, or any other guy. But for me, what I feel inside is that the main character is the city. Luanda, as itself, is the main character of the book. And these, all my characters, all the people, or the things that happen in the book, is just a way to picture Luanda as a big mess, as a big puzzle. And that's what I wanted. There is only one person in the book that's actually becoming transparent. But I think there are many people in the world, not in my book, in the world, that are becoming transparent, who are people that are there, exist, they are doing something, and we don't see them, especially the people who are in charge, politicians. They don't see those people unless they need them. So in a way, transparent, socially transparent, was mostly what I wanted to talk about. For me, even the language, the format, the length, it always depends on what am I talking about. And the thing that I like to write, it's short stories. So when I write a book, a novel, and such a big novel, I don't know even when I'm going to write another book like this, because I like to write short stories, not stories, short stories. So this is very contradictory for me, for my trajectory. I don't know why I ended up doing this, because there were too many characters, too many people. The city is too big, so I couldn't make a short story, so I made a long story. Well, the hard part was to conceal, try to bring everyone along the book, you know. There's so many voices, so many people, different layers of not only layers, different possibilities of how to tell the story. And it was very hard for me, like bringing the cows together, to bring everyone together to finish the book. For the first time, it was very, very hard for me to kill someone. This was the first time. I really thought it was a joke from other writers, that they had to kill a character. And I felt it this time was very, very, and I didn't want to do it, but there was no other way. When I finally finished it, I was very sad. I was, you know, this is over. It's a big world when you're, you know, and you're inside, and then you have to leave. You kind of, when the book is ready, you have to leave. You have to get out of there. And it's sad, you want to be there, but then it's okay, you write another book. I don't specifically identify influences. I think, you know, there's no way I can tell you this or that author. Yes, cinema, music, and also, of course, literature, they work and they go together. So it's very important for me. A poem can be very important, a particular part of a movie. Sometimes it's a tiny part, not the whole movie, and I work with that. I work a lot with things that I pick up here and there, not only movies, images, but also music. You know, music is very important for my writing, and that definitely changes my writing depending on what I'm listening. Can be jazz, classical, piano players, kora players. Could be rock, heavy rock, depending on which, you know. The transparency, I shared a list of the musicians I was listening during the book. I chose those and I had to stay with them. I could just change, but those are the, but it's just a private soundtrack. It's not, you know.